know this. You don't meet people by accident, and nothing in life happens by coincidence.
Hello?
Madam, reception inda. Nimna nodakke obru bandidare. Kelag bartira?
Kya?
Madam, someone has come to see you. Can you come down to reception, please?
Who is that?
He told your colleague.
Colleague?
Huh.
Okay, coming.
I hated him the moment I saw him. Guys can't be more annoying than this.
Please, nahi yaar. Main itna tired hu. Mujhe rest bhi lena hai. I think I got fever also.
Monisha, you have promised.
Kyun promise kiya? Next week, pakka.
You're not gonna keep your words?
Hello, kya? Emotional blackmail? ठीक है कितने बजे
मॉर्निंग सिक्स
व्हाट सो यू वांट मी टू गेट अप एट सिक्स इन द मॉर्निंग तत्व ऑन अ संडे पागल है क्या
नो एक्चुअली आई एम गोना पिक यू अप एट सिक्स सो यू हैव टू गेट अप बाय एट लीस्ट फाइव
I will be ready by 5:30.
Deal?
Whatever.
You're late. 4 minutes. Very bad.
Hello. You told you'll pick me up at 6.
But you changed to 5:30.
I was waiting inside.
And how would I know that?
You should have called me. Don't you have a phone?
That's exactly what I thought you'd do.
Seriously? Are we doing this now?
Get in.
What a great start. Everything looked pretty normal. But I didn't know that this day, this single day, is going to change the course of my life.
Track of time, you make me feel. Pata hai? Wherever I see the South Indians talking in English, no, they're always like coming, going, eating, drinking, yes sir, no. Why so much singing, yaar? Oh, you guys like singing,
I thought she was just teasing me, but I was totally wrong.
And my friend used to talk about South Indians. Mm-hmm. South Indians sit on the ground with a huge banana leaf in front of them, and then they fill it with so much rice and sambar, use both their hands to mix it, take two handful of rice and start eating like this, this. And you know when the rice leaks, what they do? It is like, they do this, How you guys eat, yaar? Hey, why everyone in South India spit on everything when they get angry?
What?
You know what happened? Once I was going in a cab, an auto guy came and hit him. You know what he did? He went, he got from the cab, he went near the auto guy. You know what he was like? Hey, thoo! Why, yaar? Why you guys do this, man? Have you seen DDLJ? That's my favorite childhood movie, you know?
DD what?
Oh my god! Have you not seen it?
Haven't even heard of it.
Seriously, man. You should go and die.
Ask me to watch it, no. Why are you asking me to die?
No! Just go and die! Why South Indians don't learn Hindi?
Why should they learn that?
Because Hindi is our national language.
And who said that?
Do you know Hindi?
No.
So, do you have a girlfriend?
Me?
Hmm.
No.
Good.
Do you have a boyfriend?
Of course.
Interesting. So what's your story?
I'm in love with this guy. He is engaged to another girl. Soon he's gonna get married.
This is the most pathetic love story I ever heard, you know? I mean, that is really sad to hear.
I know he still loves me. His situations.
I hope you're right. So, what's your hobbies?
Photography. So, do you have any hobbies?
Yeah, I love traveling. I travel a lot.
Oh, roaming guy, huh?
Hello. Explorer, okay?
Yeah, yeah. Explorer, it seems.
What's so special in your state?
Nothing. Everything is same.
Nothing. Come on, man. There must be something special, right? Or unique about it, like people, place, culture.
Everything is so normal, man. No big deal.
Not even food?
Just how others cook.
This is the point where God was signaling me to run far away from her. But I failed to interpret it. Where do you come from exactly?
Delhi.
First time in Bangalore?
First time in whole South India.
Great. So what do you know about South India?
South Indians... Apart from Madrasis... No, nothing.
Seriously? You call South people Madrasis?
Yeah, what else?
So this is your third day in Bangalore. What do you like the most in Bangalore?
Nothing. Oh my God. Why so much traffic, man? Like, I don't understand how people are living here.
Hello. People like you and me did this, okay? Immigrants. If we all go back to our hometown, Bangalore city would be neat, clean and sweet like before. Stop complaining on things that you are responsible for.
You know, population is the main reason why India is struggling to grow?
No, I don't know. That's a deep thought.
Yeah. You know, some people, they struggle to find a place in India, so they start going out of country and they face a lot of discrimination.
Discrimination?
Huh, due to racism.
Oh. So you know the word. Good.
Yeah. And you remember a few years back how in Australia so many Indians were beaten up because of the same reason?
Well, that's what happens when you go to Australia and ask them to learn Hindi. They will beat the shit out of you. You see that poets over there? V.K. Goka, Kuvempu, Dr. Anantamurthy. They're the big heritage of Karnataka. Very big poets out there.
Nice.
Yeah.
See, I'm telling you.
Mm-hmm.
If we all Indians are united by one single language, no. Then I think nobody on this earth can shake us.
And that language is Hindi.
Mm.
You know what's the difference between North Indians and British?
What?
Nothing. No difference at all.
Irritating me is your only intention, hai kya?
Oh, what about you? I've been watching you since morning. You've been insulting me ever since we met. Trust me, I'm trying to be such a good host, but you're not letting me to.
Hello, that was not insulting. That was the harsh truth I was talking about.
So did I. Why are you getting annoyed by that?
You know what? I think we should stop doing this.
What?
Right now, I feel so much enmity with you that I don't want to continue this yet anymore.
Get lost. Even I don't want to be with a racist like you.
Excuse me? You literally begged me to come out with you, okay? Begged.
First of all, it was not begging. I did a favor to you and you said you'll do anything for me. I asked you out and you agreed. Now where is this begging come into picture?
Whatever, I'm leaving. And by the way, it was really crap knowing you. Goodbye.
Aayi doktar nimmachi.
Did you just call me in the local language?
No.
Don't lie. That sounded like a really bad word.
Little.
That is why I hate Madrasis.
Okay, cool.
You are the most annoying creature I've seen in my life.
Hello. We will never learn Hindi, okay? Get lost.
You get lost.
We were not supposed to be together. It was not meant that way. That was visible in every single thing we tried. It's better to depart than to stay together and fight. At least that's what I thought. But...
What now?
I want to go back to my hotel.
Go on. Who's stopping you?
I don't know where it is.
What?
I don't know the area name.
This is the most pathetic situation I've ever seen.
हो गया? Done with your ugly laughter?
Somewhat. You don't even remember your hotel or area name?
Everything is in my laptop.
I'm going to tell you only 2 times. You got to listen to me very carefully, okay? Kono panagara.
Hello. Kya? Slow, okay? Slow.
Too bad. Fine. Now listen to me very carefully. I'm going to tell only once, Konopanagrara. Oh, you missed it, didn't you?
Could you repeat it one last time? Let's go to hotel.
Don't you have any shame calling a guy to a hotel?
Hello, drop me at my hotel. Asshole.
Did I just hear you call me asshole?
No. Please, yaar, drop me at my hotel, no.
That's not where I'm going.
Then where are you going?
I have this itinerary of mine. And I need to follow that.
Who cares whether you follow it or not?
Well, I do. So when I go through your area, I'll just drop you there. Until then, you're free to stick with me.
How long will it take?
Listen, it is my responsibility to take you back to your hotel safely. But now, it's not the time. Come on, there are so many places to visit. It'll be fun, trust me.
You should not annoy me.
And you should not insult South.
Deal.
Truce.
It was nothing short of a miracle that we got together again. We acknowledged our differences and agreed on the fact that we disagree on a lot of things. We started understanding each other.
Dream.
Why would a guy want to date with you? Is he sexually attracted to you or something else? There is one way to find out.
Okay, propose.
Excuse me?
It's okay, do it.
Do what?
See, I'm not a kid, okay?
Okay.
And I know why guys bring a girl out, even when she doesn't like it.
Seriously, jump to the point.
I think you wanna propose me. And you can do that now.
You read my mind. Are you ready?
Yeah. Look at my face and propose.
Sorry, habit. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I love.
Go on, yeah.
And really love.
Yeah. You didn't bring me out to propose me.
No.
You're not attracted to me?
Well, the question is tricky, but no.
If you're not interested in me, then why did you bring me out?
You thought I brought you out to propose you.
Yeah. See, I know about boys, okay? They always have this intention. They don't do anything randomly.
That's not true.
So tell me.
Tell you what?
If you're not attracted, then why'd you bring me out?
See, it doesn't have to be sexual all the times, okay?
It is sexual all the time for boys.
You have a wrong perception on boys.
Karthik. Look at me. At the end of the day, every date ends on bed in North. This is the way. Are you sure you don't want to propose me?
That is not my intention.
I'm in a good mood. I might say yes. Seriously, you should try.
You're saying I need to use the word love in order to sleep with you.
Yes. That's how it works. You see? You need to make me feel comfortable. You know that we're not gonna meet again, right? So, this is your only chance. Don't regret later.
Shocking. I think I judged her too early. Why was she doing this? I really have no intention of that sort, okay?
Just say it. Don't feel shy.
Is everyone like you in the North? I mean, I should not just judge people by looking at one girl. But you are scaring me.
Are you gay?
Are you a nymphomaniac?
What? Okay, just tell me. If not love or sex, then what is your intention in bringing a girl out?
Monisha, I just want to know about you. That's all. See, you come from a different background. You eat different food. You speak different language. And you have this different custom. I just want to know about all that. That's all.
So, are you just looking for a friend from North?
Maybe.
So, why are you so curious about knowing people?
Aren't you curious?
Me? No, not at all.
Strange.
What makes him so interesting?
Everything.
So, what's your passion?
My passion, my hobby, all are just traveling, traveling and traveling.
What do you get out of traveling, huh? No, tell me, seriously. You go to some 10 places, click some 100 pictures, and then you come back home. Why are you so obsessed with traveling?
You have no idea what's the real meaning of traveling, isn't it? It's not just visiting places. It's about discovering yourself. When you go to a new place, see something new, you're not just exploring that place, you're exploring yourself. I have this curiosity, you know, to know about people, their culture, their tradition, where they live, what food they eat. I mean, only when I travel, I feel like I'm alive. A solo bullet ride on a hill station road. Foggy forest. Tent in the middle of the valley. Sound of flowing river. Campfire at night. Breathing fresh air. Won't you like all those things? Especially when you get a chance to capture every single moment of your traveling in your camera.
This is exactly where he touched my soul.
It excites me. You guys built a temple for a bull?
Yeah.
Please don't take me in a wrong way. But what is your problem in learning Hindi? Why are you guys saying no to it? I mean, won't you like it if we could all speak in one single language? Wouldn't it be great?
See, I totally understand your concern.
Really?
Yeah. If you both start speaking in Hindi rather than English, you feel you're very close to me, right?
Yeah, exactly.
That's exactly what every localite wants to feel. Don't you get it? You go to a local shop, talk to that person in local language. Don't speak fluently. Just talk in two or three words. Look how happy he feels and how he treats you back. That's how you earn their respect. However closer we get, these cultural differences keep popping up between us every now and then. How to make her understand. Whenever you go to every state of this country, you feel you're in a different country, right? That's because every state is a country of its own. They have their own tradition, culture, and language. India has never been a single country before British. And you cannot bring this whole country under one single language.
I just wanted to talk in a common language with my own country people. That's it.
I totally understand that. But that is not possible in India. This country is something beyond that. We have 22 official languages. 22. We celebrate 11 New Years. You know, you just have to come out of your home, your social media, your government, and look at this country as it is. Only then you'll understand how unique and beautiful this country is. You just have to respect the people and their choices. That's it. Respect.
Respect your people and their choices. True.
Inandukudi?
ಮಗ ಒಂದ್ ನಿಮಿಷ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಒಂದ್ ನಿಮಿಷ
ಕಾರ್ತಿಕ್ ಟೀಚ್ ಮೀ ಫ್ಯೂ ಪೊಲೈಟ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕನ್ನಡನೋ
ವೈ ಡು ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ನೋ
ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಇಂಪ್ರೆಸ್ ದ ಲೋಕಲ್ ಪೀಪಲ್
ರಿಯಲಿ
ಯಾ
ಓಕೆ ಹೌ ಪೊಲೈಟ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ
ವೆರಿ ಪೊಲೈಟ್
ಓಕೆ ರೆಡಿ
ಯಾ
ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಸೇ Add Nin Ajji before that.
Tell it again.
Nin Ajji.
Nin Ajji.
Exactly. If you wanted to be more polite, append Le with Nin Ajji.
Oh, just the way we use G for more respect.
Exactly. The stronger you say Le, the polite it sounds for them.
Okay, repeat it again.
Le ninnaji.
Le ninnaji. Okay. Le ninnaji. Le ninnaji. Le ninnaji. Is it right?
Exactly.
Okay. Thank you.
All the best. Enjoy. Sayulu maga.
ಕನ್ನಡ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ವಾ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕೊಡಿ ನಿನ್ನ ಅಜ್ಜಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಡೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ಮನೆ ಬರಲ್ವಾ ನಾಟಕ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ನಾಟಕ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಕುದ್ದು ಸಾಯಿಸ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಏಯ್ ಹೇಳೋ ಯಾರೋ ನಿನ್ನ ಕಳ್ಸ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಯಾರು ಕಳ್ಸ್ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಹೇಳೋ ಯಾರು ಕಳ್ಸ್ಕೊಟ್ರೆ ಹೇಳೋ
ಕಾರ್ತಿಕ್
ಕಾರ್ತಿಕ್ ಯಾರ ಬೆಕ್ಕಿನ ಕಣ್ ಕಾರ್ತಿಕ್ನ ಕರ್ಸು ನನ್ಗವ ಬೇಕಿವಾಗ ಕರ್ಸು ಕರ್ಸು ಬರ ಕೇಳು ಲೇ ಮಗ ಅವ್ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ನನ್ನಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಲೇ ನಿನ್ನ ಅಜ್ಜಿ ಕೊಡು ಅಂತಾಳೆ ಮರೇ ಏಯ್ ನೋಡೋ ಮರೇ ಹಿಂಗಿಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಇಲ್ಲಿಟ್ಟು ಹಿಂಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಇಲ್ಲಿಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ ಇವ್ರು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಅಂತ ಬಿಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಹೊರಟೋಗೋ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡ್ತವೆ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ
ಕಾರ್ತಿಕ್ ಆಲ್ ರಾಂಗ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್
ಹೇ ಮಗ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ
Why did you do this, huh? Why did you do this?
Monisha,
do you have any idea how those buffaloes have treated me?
You need to understand why I did that.
Why? Why, huh?
You wanted to meet localites, right?
Yeah, so?
This is the way.
Sale!
Oh my god, are you serious? Not the phone, not the shirt. Monisha, not shirt. Monisha, stop hitting me. It's paining, yaar. Okay, stop it. Monisha, stop it. Listen to me, Monisha. Oh, that's bad. That's bad. That's really bad.
Why did I even come out with you, huh? Nobody messes with me. Nobody. They abused me?
As if you understood everything.
If you want to live, don't talk.
Actually, I...
You want to die?
No.
Shut up then. And everything is alright. There's a breeze coming in the window. And you're leaning over me, warm shadow. Track of time. I'm a feminist.
Who cares? You know what?
Mm-hmm.
This is Narayan Murthy's house.
Kya, sach mein?
Yeah. And this is Nandan Nilekani's house.
Oh my god. Such big houses.
Yeah. You see that balcony over there? 1, 2...
Oh yeah, that one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Every day after dinner, they come to that balcony and have a good conversation with each other. Nice, no?
Sorry. Do you think I'm a fool? Huh? Do you think I'm so dumb?
Yes. No.
Sorry.
Why are you hitting me? Monisha, stop hitting me. Why are you hitting me?
What do you think? Do I look like a chutia?
Stop hitting me.
Okay, tell me what is the meaning of bhaji?
What? Nimajji.
Yeah, that only. What is the meaning of it?
It means your grandmother.
Why are you going to my grandmother, huh?
It's a local slang used to scold people in Canada.
Okay, come here. Come here. I won't hit you. Come here.
Okay.
So tell me the truth. Is this really Narayan Murthy's house? You make me
feel like I'm the sun in your outer space. I really have no idea about that.
This is
your boyfriend?
My tour guide. Free for whole day. Slow song playing on the radio. Birds singing about what they know. A new day comes in slow. The sunlight dancing in a light show.
Petrol is over. Get down. Let's push.
I am not pushing the bike.
At least get down and walk with me, no?
Hello. Is this the way you treat a girl? Making her walk, asking her to push the bike? Oh my God. Am I really in South India?
Okay. Stay. Let me push.
This is for messing with me. That's all. Respect over. Idiot. Where are we? How are you going to get the petrol? I don't see any gas stations nearby.
Excuse me. It's not how I'm going to get the petrol. It's how we are gonna get it. Okay?
Whatever.
Let's rest for some time and then go look for it.
Met you in the winter when I was a mystery. It was cold but I was full of fire. And you said you like my wild eyes and strong mind. You like sunshine. Oh, my midnight's a late youth and I belong to you. Soaking in the full moons, I fall for your laughter. You hold me together, got me feeling like I'm brand new. And I keep telling myself, don't waste it. Got a good thing, don't change it. I got a lot to lose now that I've got you. And I was wishing for the best, I have it. You and me got Hollywood magic. Never gonna give it up.
Chalo, I'll help you.
On fire, 'cause you kept me. Every time I mess it up, and everybody says that things are bound to change, but I hope they stay the same. 'Cause you are the best thing that's ever happened to me. I was not the type to slow down my life for you. I was young and I was full of fire. Now I could walk a tightrope, balance with my eyes closed. This is how life goes. Oh, in midnights of late youth, I belong to you. And I'm breathing in the still nights. I live for the moments where I am floating. And you're the only thing on my mind. You got me setting all I know on fire. 'Cause you time I mess it up, and everybody says that things are bound to change, but I hope they stay the same. 'Cause you are the best thing that's ever happened to me. You got me setting all I know on fire. You kept me every time I mess it up, and everybody says that things are bound to change. But I hope they stay the same, 'cause you are the best thing that's ever happened to me.
She made me say this.
Wow, what a girl.
Yeah, I see it all with my eyes closed. I'm never gonna let you go. You are the thrill of my life. Oh, of my life. Oh.
One question was troubling me. Why would someone dump a girl like Monisha? What is it that a guy doesn't like in her?
The city has a beautiful weather, actually.
So tell me about your past life.
Why do you want to know about my past life?
I want to know what happened between you two.
Huh, curiosity.
Something like that.
It's not a big deal, man. It's bakwas, actually.
Let's hear it.
Why do you want to hear it?
Because I want to know why he dumped you.
Trust me, it's not that big story for your time at all.
Start.
Where do you want me to start?
From the beginning?
Okay. So a girl goes to cat training after college. There she meets a guy. They become friends. They become really good friends. Coaching completes. The guy gets a job. He moves to a far off place. And then he starts calling her every day and telling her that he's missing her. He's feeling lonely and stuff. And after a point, he proposes her. She likes him too. And then he starts coming, you know, just to meet her. He comes once in a while just to meet her. Even she falls in love with him. You know, she gets attached to him so much that she starts imagining her entire life with him. She couldn't distance from him at all. She trusts him so much. She trusts him so much that she gives him everything. And then he starts showing his true colors. He starts ignoring her. She doesn't know what to do. She can't take it. And then one day randomly he just comes and he's like he wants to break up. She's shocked and she asks him why. And the reason he gives her breaks her deep.
And what is that?
He says, my mother doesn't like short girls. She will never accept you and this marriage will never happen. Whom am I sharing all this with?
I wish I could undo what I did. I thought it was funny, but it's beyond serious.
Thank you.
Hello, Arjun? Why are you avoiding me?
Monisha, please stop calling me again and again.
What did I do?
Yaar, understand my situation, na? I really can't do anything against my mom at this moment. Okay?
So you took your mom's permission when you slept with me? What do you want?
What do you mean, Monisha?
Will you stay with me if I become taller?
That is not possible.
Will you stay with me if I increase my height?
Monisha, I'm already engaged.
What?
I'm sorry.
Is she taller than me?
Monisha, that is not necessary.
Just tell me, is she taller than me?
Why are you even asking this?
I just want to know.
Yes.
I hate boys.
I know.
You know the lovemaking we had? He made me feel so comfortable. You know how happy I was?
No, I don't. Tell me more.
Mm.
Do I look ugly?
You look short. The shorter you are, the cuter you look. Monisha, look at me.
Far, far away from my home, a stranger from a place I'd never visited, speaks the language I'd never heard before, follows a culture I never cared about, becomes my friend, with whom I can share anything in this world and still not be judged. If this is not strange, I don't know what else is. Meeting Karthik was not planned, but I'm glad it happened. One thing I underestimated about Karthik was his ability to read people in and out. A simple white shirt, blue jeans, and a funny hairstyle. It's tempting to judge him when you see him for the first time. But he surprised me.
You wanted to ask me something at the restaurant, no?
Yeah.
Ask, no.
Do you know what is cognitive dissonance?
Cognitive what?
It happens when there is a disagreement between our heart and head. When this happens, our thoughts, beliefs, attitude will become inconsistent.
I'm not getting you.
Let's say I have a lot of talent and I have all the knowledge in this world and I deserve the best of best. You're following me, right? But the job I do every day is shit. They treat me like shit and the salary I get is shit. But somewhere I get convinced myself that this is what I deserve. But the other part of me tells me that I deserve better. You know what happens now? I start fighting with myself every day. This fight will slowly destroy me. Makes me hopeless. Makes me go antisocial. Even makes me forget what I really love in my life. Photography.
Karthik, careful.
Let me get this straight. Being ignored by the person you love is difficult. But if the person is treating you like shit, then generally he doesn't give a shit, Monisha.
Stop it, Karthik. I'm serious.
Do you know what is the first sign of true love, Monisha? Treating your loved one with utmost respect, Monisha. Respect.
Hold it right there.
I don't think he still loves you anymore. You need to stop this and move on.
I said that is enough. I know he loves me. I don't have to prove it to anyone, okay? I just happened to be the girl who
couldn't let him go and forget him.
It's a mistake that I let you talk so much.
I didn't say anything wrong.
No, it's not about being wrong. I let you come too personal.
I'm just trying to help my friend, Monisha.
You're not my friend, Karthik.
Oh.
It's another mistake that I called you friend.
A stranger then.
Exactly.
Monisha, you're so used to your features that you don't know how do you look to a stranger like me. Choose who chooses you.
This conversation is over. Drop me to my hotel or just leave.
What?
I think we're done.
Monisha doesn't need to end this way.
I warned you, Karthik.
Fine. I'll drop you wherever you want, but before that, just have one last dinner with me. Let's finish this in a proper way. After that, you'll never get to see me ever again. Just a small token of respect.
My whole day was a nonsense. Few minutes, I can adjust. Are you coming or not?
1 minute.
The first sign of true love is treating your loved one with the utmost respect. I slowly started realizing every word Karthik said was true. But how could I forget him? I know that he doesn't love me. I know he doesn't respect me. And I know very well that he doesn't even consider me as a human. But I love him deeply. I just don't know how to stop it, nor come out of it. I'm stuck.
Mm-hmm.
I'm angry on Karthik. How does he even know my private life? Am I too predictable to a stranger? Or Karthik is someone more than a stranger who can feel what I'm going through every day? I feel I should apologize for what I said.
Beautiful.
Frickin' moralist.
That's rude.
Rude? Look who's talking. You don't even have the courtesy to say sorry for offending a girl, and you are talking about rudeness.
See, you need to understand the...
Sorry, bolo.
Listen, no.
Sorry, bolo.
Will you let me talk?
Say sorry.
I'm sorry.
For?
For?
Are? What are you sorry for?
All right. I'm sorry. I offended a very good girl. Even though I was right.
Okay, here we go.
I think I need to work on my articulation skills and improve my arguments rather than increasing my voice.
Exactly. See, that's what I like from you.
What?
You pinpoint the actual root cause of the problem.
Oh, you're appreciating me now. Wow.
See how good I am? You need enormous talent to actually appreciate other people.
Unbelievable.
Shh, it's him. Hello?
Tell me one thing.
Yeah?
Did you put all our intimate pictures on Facebook?
Intimate?
I mean, the pictures we took when we were in relationship.
I don't know, that was a long time ago. What happened?
You didn't remove it?
I don't know. I think I forgot. Why? What happened?
You forgot.
Yeah? And you want me to remove them?
Do you have any idea what happened? Because you forgot to remove it!
What?
Why are you spoiling my life here? Why can't you just go away and leave me in peace?
What did I do?
You won't stop, right? You will keep on bugging me throughout my life.
I didn't mean to disturb you.
Do you have data pack?
Huh?
Can you connect to internet?
Yeah.
Okay, I want you to put the phone on speaker. Open Facebook app.
Yeah?
Go to photos.
Okay.
Field trips.
Hmm?
Close to my heart albums.
Yeah?
How many pictures are you seeing?
44.
Delete everything permanently.
Everything?
Are you listening?
Yeah.
Do it. Deleting.
Yeah.
I'm still seeing them.
I'm done.
Don't lie, Monisha. Delete those two pictures.
How is this hurting your image? We're in a group, right?
Just delete.
Yeah, I'm done.
Good. Now go to your gallery.
What?
I said go to your fucking gallery.
No, I'm not going.
Monisha, shall I die? Will you be happy? That's what you want, right?
No, please, yaar. Don't do this to me. You know how much these pictures mean to me, right?
Monisha, I promise I will commit suicide. Delete all.
He was mentally harassing her. I was helpless looking at my friend being destroyed by some moron.
No, please. I beg you, I promise, I will not call you, I will not disturb you, I will not put or upload any pictures on Facebook, I will not message you. Please, yaar, please don't make me go through all this.
Fine, watch me. People will call you. My whole family will be crying. Enjoy.
Listen. Monisha, listen to me.
He wants me to delete all the pictures.
It's okay. You hear me? It is okay. Let it go.
I really can't.
Look at me. Remember? Respect? He doesn't want to be in your life. He doesn't want you to be in his life either. Respect that. Trust me, you'll be fine. Let it go. Respect. That's all.
I deleted all the pictures.
Thank you so much.
Monisha, you deserve better. Okay?
Suddenly I felt like I lost the purpose to live. Take me with you next time when you travel. I shoot and you explore.
Okay.
One was breaking me, another one was fixing me, and both were happening at the same time.
Monisha leaves Bangalore early morning. I knew that because I was on the same call when she threatened our manager to put down her papers if she was not sent back home. He agreed. It didn't bother me that time. But the fact that I won't see her again bothers me now. You wanna have tea?
No, it's getting late. I think I need to go.
It's nearby, it'll just take 10 minutes.
No, I really have to go.
Okay.
Okay.
Maybe you should consider staying here for one more week.
Why? Is there any other place in Bangalore left to show me? I enjoyed.
My pleasure. Stay with me, Monisha. Forever.
Thank you.
What time is your flight?
early morning.
You want me to drop you?
No, the cab is already arranged.
Cool then. Until we meet again. But not sure when.
Take care.
It was a lie, right? That you said you'll travel with me?
I don't say things just for the sake of saying, okay?
But we don't know when we're gonna meet again.
We will, soon.
You know what? You're not letting people get into your life who really cares about you.
And I really don't know who that is.
You just have to see it clearly.
Bye, Karthik.
Monisha feared all human relations. She thought, one day everyone is going to hurt her no matter what. I think I came into her life at a very wrong time. I felt lonely.
You know, you are just one decision away from a totally different life.
If someone wants to go out of your life, let them go. Respect their decision. After all, you can't force anyone to like you. Not sure why Karthik came into my mind when he asked that question. Hello?
Monisha, Shushmit here.
Yeah, tell me.
Okay, I saw your messages. Are you serious?
Yeah.
If I transfer you to Bangalore, you won't get any allowances. You should know this.
Yeah, I'm aware of that.
Okay, fine. I will initiate it.
Thank you. If someone wants to get into your life for a betterment, let them in. I know we have so many differences. From the language till the mindset, there is literally nothing common between us. But here we are, liking each other for some reason, and I don't know what it is. Are we gonna fall in love? I don't know. Are we gonna remain friends? I don't know that either. It all depends on time. I'm not gonna break my head thinking about how my life with him is going to be. I leave it to time. I neither have the knowledge nor the capacity to plan till that extent. Right now, I have 10 minutes and I'm going to have a hot tea with the best person I met in my life. Seriously, Karthik, when I first met you, honestly, I didn't know you were going to be this important to me.